Now let's discuss the political reasons for the revolt of 1857. Now what are those political factors? First, effective control. Secondly, subsidiary alliance. And thirdly, doctrine of lapse. We all have heard of these British policies for conquest in India. Now, what is effective control? Effective control can be termed as the broader or summation of all British policies to maintain de facto control over India. So what it is? Summation of all British policies for what purpose? To maintain de facto control over India. Clear? Next comes doctrine of lapse. We might all have heard of policies doctrine of lapse. So what is doctrine of lapse? What is doctrine of lapse? This was introduced by Lord Dalhousie. Now, who was Dalhousie? He was the Governor General of India from 1848 to 56. So first, introduced by Lord Dalhousie, or we can write Dalhousie. Who was he? Governor General. Time from 1848 to 56. Now, this single policy of Lord Dalhousie is believed to be the major factor which led to revolt of 1857. How? According to historian, under doctrine of lapse, Lord Dalhousie captured 1/4 of a million miles of Indian territory, or we can say 250,000 miles of Indian territory. Now, what are the features of doctrine of lapse? The features of doctrine of lapse are, so under doctrine of lapse, it was mandatory for the Indian princely state who did not produce natural heir to take permission of British government before adopting a son. So what does it mean? To adopt a son, princely state has to take permission. Please remember that only those princely state who have not produced natural heir. Other features, the adopted son can inherit the private property of his father, but not the state. So can inherit private property of father or foster father, but not the state. For example, Damodar Rao, Gangadhar Rao and Rani Lakshmibai. These three people we know about. Rani Lakshmibai, Queen of Jhansi. Gangadhar Rao, King of Jhansi. Their son Damodar Rao. Now Damodar Rao can inherit the private property of Rani Lakshmibai as well as Gangadhar, but not the state of Jhansi. This was under doctrine of lapse. Clear? So this policy is considered as a reactionary policy by the princely state. Now what are those princely state annexed by the British under doctrine of lapse? It is said 8 princely states were captured under doctrine of lapse. हाउ मेनी 8. वॉट आर दोज? दोज प्रिंसली स्टेट्स आर फर्स्ट सतारा, सेकेंड संभलपुर, नेक्स्ट जयपुर, नेक्स्ट भगत, नेक्स्ट उदयपुर, नेक्स्ट नागपुर, नेक्स्ट झांसी एंड लास्ट अवध. क्लियर? सो दीज वेयर द 8 स्टेट्स एनेक्स्ड बाय ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट ऑन द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स, ऑन द प्रिटेक्स ऑफ डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स इन इंडिया. सतारा ईयर 1848, संभलपुर 1849, जयपुर 1849, भगत 1850, उदयपुर 1850, नागपुर 1854, झांसी 1855, अवध 1856. क्लियर? सो दीज वेयर द 8 स्टेट. नाउ वी कैन डेनोट दीज 8 एनेक्स स्टेट अंडर डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स ऑन इंडियन मैप. दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन हिस्ट्री. पर्टिकुलरली फॉर हिस्ट्री ऑप्शनल. नाउ संभलपुर इन ओडिशा और छत्तीसगढ़ बॉर्डर, जयपुर यूपी नियर बुंदेलखंड, भगत हिमाचल प्रदेश, सतारा महाराष्ट्र, उदयपुर वी ऑल नो राजस्थान, नागपुर अगेन महाराष्ट्र, झांसी वी नो यूपी बुंदेलखंड रीजन. सो दीज वेयर द लिस्ट ऑफ स्टेट्स विच वर एनेक्स्ड बाय द ब्रिटिश अंडर डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स. प्लीज कीप इन माइंड दीज इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स. नाउ टू एड अ बिट ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा डेटा, वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लॉर्ड डलहौजी व्हेन ही वॉज द गवर्नर जनरल ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम 1848 टू 56. सो लेट्स टेक सम लिस्ट ऑफ पॉलिसीज introduced by Dalhousie while he was Governor General. What are those policies? For the first time, railway network or railway line or a train ran between Bombay to Thane. Under whose governorship? Lord Dalhousie. 1853. What it is? Railway line. Another, Pegu, Lower Burma, was annexed and made part of British Indian Empire. Pegu or Lower Burma captured. Other, telegraph line for the first time was introduced in India. Telegraph line, introduction of telegraph line. Others, introduction of widow remarriage bill. Now this bill can also come under the socio-religious factor which led to the revolt of 1857. Please keep in mind, widow remarriage bill was introduced by Lord Dalhousie, but it was passed by the last Governor General of India, Lord Canning. Please keep in mind important data, passed by Lord Canning. Now, what were the another policies or data regarding Lord Dalhousie? Wood's dispatch came during his tenure. How is it important, Wood's dispatch? It is considered as the Magna Carta of education in India. क्लियर. सो दीज वेयर द ब्रॉडर अदर देन द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स पॉलिसीज ऑफ लॉर्ड डलहौजी, विडो रिमैरिज बिल, एनेक्सेशन ऑफ पेगू और लोअर बर्मा, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ टेलीग्राफ लाइन और रेलवे लाइन बिटवीन बॉम्बे टू थाने एंड वुड्स डिस्पैच विच सर्व्ड एज द मैग्ना कार्टा ऑफ एजुकेशन इन इंडिया. क्लियर. सो दिस वॉज डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट पॉलिटिकल पॉलिसीज ऑफ ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट, दैट वॉज सब्सिडियरी अलायंस. सब्सिडियरी अलायंस. नाउ वॉट इज सब्सिडियरी अलायंस? वी कैन से सब्सिडियरी अलायंस इज अ पॉलिसी थ्रू विच द इंडियन प्रिंसली स्टेट लॉस्ट दियर सॉवरनिटी इन इंडिया. सो वी कैन ऑलवेज से इन बेसिक लेमन टर्म अ पॉलिसी अंडर विच ब्रिटिश और द प्रिंसली स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया लॉस्ट दियर सॉवरनिटी. सॉवरनिटी. नाउ हु इंट्रोड्यूस सब्सिडियरी अलायंस? सब्सिडियरी अलायंस इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लॉर्ड वेलेस्ली. लॉर्ड वेलेस्ली. हु वॉज लॉर्ड वेलेस्ली? ही वॉज द गवर्नर जनरल फ्रॉम 1798 टू 1805. क्लियर. वॉट आर द अदर फीचर्स ऑफ द सब्सिडियरी अलायंस? अंडर सब्सिडियरी अलायंस इंडियन प्रिंसली स्टेट cannot possess their own army. So, cannot possess own army. Now, the British or the East India Company will protect the princely state or the rulers from internal as well as foreign invasion. Protect princely state from internal plus external invasion. What does princely state has to do in return for? The princely state has to pay for the maintenance of army. So what it has to do? Pay for maintenance. Pay for maintenance. Now, what are the other features? A permanent British diplomat must be placed in the princely state. So we can say other feature, posting of a British diplomat. Other features, what else we can say about subsidiary alliance? Under subsidiary alliance, the princely state became or functioned as a protectorate. Functioned as a protectorate. Now, another important feature of subsidiary alliance was, no, the princely state was not allowed to have contact with foreigners like French, like Dutch, etc. So, no contact with foreigners like French. So these were the features of subsidiary alliance introduced by Wellesley, under which the princely state can have no army, will be protected internally or externally by the British Indian Army, or in return for the regular maintenance for the army, plus a permanent British diplomat must be posted, and the princely state functioned as a protectorate of the British, and also they should not maintain any contacts with foreigners like French, Dutch, etc. So these were the features of subsidiary alliance. Now in the next part we will discuss what were those states which came under the subsidiary alliance. See, here we must keep in mind, subsidiary alliance in a loose based form was first introduced by फ्रेंच गवर्नर डुप्ले. सो सब्सिडियरी अलायंस इन अ लूज फॉर्म वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय फ्रेंच गवर्नर डुप्ले बट सब्सिडियरी अलायंस इन अ प्रॉपर पॉलिसी फ्रेमवर्क वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाई लॉर्ड वेलेसली विच वी आर स्टडिंग इन 1798. बट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन इंडिया इन अ लूजली बेस्ड फॉर्म इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाई डुप्ले. नाउ यू मस्ट ऑल्सो रिमेंबर अवध बिकेम पार्ट ऑफ सब्सिडियरी अलायंस लूज बेस्ड फॉर्म under treaty of allahabad to be protected against marathas. So Awadh came under subsidiary alliance after the battle of Buxar under treaty of allahabad to be protected from the attack of marathas. Who will protect them? Robert Clive will protect them, or British East India Company will protect them. Clear? Now subsidiary alliance, when it was introduced in 1798, what are those states which were captured under this? First, Hyderabad. Secondly, Mysore after the fourth Anglo-Mysore War, after the death of Tipu Sultan. Hyderabad year 1798, Mysore 1799. Next comes Tanjore. Next comes Awadh. Next comes Peshwa. Next Sindhia. Next Gaikwad. Now these three are part of Maratha Confederacy or Maratha Pentarchy. Just will take what Marathas formed Pentarchy, which means rule of five. There are five Maratha families. One, Holkar. They ruled from Indore. Peshwa from Pune. Next, Sindhia from Gwalior. Next, Bhonsle from Nagpur. Last, Gaikwad from Baroda. So these were the five Pentarchy of Marathas. We must remember Holkar of Indore, Peshwa of Pune, Gaikwad of Baroda, Bhonsle of from Nagpur, Sindhia from Gwalior, and out of which they became part of subsidiary alliance. Gaikwad in 1803, Sindhia in 1803, Peshwa in 1802, Awadh in 1801, Tanjore in 1799. So these were the list of princely state which were captured under the subsidiary alliance, and this was the part of political policy which led to the revolt of 1857, which we must remember at all costs.